Hello, hello, hello. Guys, I think, it's very interesting to be alive in our times. I've been asked a particular question that what should you do when you are in love with someone that you may never or you can't have? Very interesting question. It's like when you try and ask a question whether is there anything called a partner that was created for another person. Those are very intriguing questions which we need to interrogate seriously. And sometimes I'm asked questions whether why then there is so much imbalances between men and women, where sometimes you find that you will have more women than men. Then what should happen in instances like that? So questions like that, they always challenge me and they make me think and try and go to the spiritual level and try and think deep to try and ask for answers, because it's not easy to say real what should happen when you are in love with someone that you can't have, especially when that question is asked by a woman. Because normally if it's a man will try and pursue his interest by making sure that he's going all out there and looking for that particular woman. But I'm not so sure, because it's 21st century as well. So women, maybe they are at liberty to go out there and look for love. So who knows? And who said women they should not do that? It's not like before in some olden times where it was not okay for a woman to go out there and say, "Hey, I'm in love with you." But in our days, women, they can do that. But the key question is that what should you do when you are in love with a person that you cannot have? I think it simply means if you can't make an effort and you don't have guts to approach or tell that person, it will mean that we have to live with it and accept it that you can't have that person. And a person asked me that, does it stop me as a woman if a person is married that I cannot tell this person? Wow, very interesting, because in our days we have men who are polygamists. But I'm not so sure if it's you approaching him, whether he can take you seriously, respect you, and honor you. Probably if he sees that you are genuine, that man would not hesitate to say, "Okay, why don't we then consider this or try it?" Probably it will work or it might not work. But I'm simply saying sometimes it's not everything that we wish we can have that we can have, or we can, really get close to our hearts. Particular love. It's unfortunately that sometimes we might see at a distance that people that should be in our lives, they are with people whom we say they are wrong. How do we say this? It's because sometimes when you see a person that you really love and you know that you will treat that particular person better, with passion and with respect, being abused or being neglected or mistreated by that person whom you might say, in his life at that time, it becomes a problem. But I'm simply saying, sometimes we have to live with things that we really, when we think we can't say we can live with them. I'm struggling. I know that sometimes if you are a man, for example, if you love someone and that person is married, surely you can't have that person. But I'm not so sure about a woman. Maybe we need to think further about these issues, because we might take them lightly and think they are easy to address, yet they are not easy at all, because maybe if you make an effort, that effort can work very well for you. So I'm simply saying, go out there and express your love for that particular person that you love. It's the same thing where people, they limit themselves and saying they are looking for their partners whom they believe were created for them somewhere for them. I don't believe in that. I believe in the mere fact that If you meet a person and you fall in love with that person, and both of you agree that you can take a journey, be it in a relationship, in a form of a relationship, or in a form of marriage, what you both agree upon at that particular time, the gods join in and support that, and agree that exactly that is the relationship. Because you can imagine, we meet some people. We miss other people. So how do we make of that? And I don't think that somewhere there were people who are so unfortunate that their partners were never created. It will be really crazy for me that God can create a person here and then don't create your partner. For what? I really can't understand that. I will never accept that you as a person, you were so unfortunate so much that our creator who created all of us decided not to create a partner for you. For what good reason? I don't think we are serving an unfair and unjust God who can just create inequalities from the onset, because then that is going to cause a havoc. If things like that happens, it simply means it's going to cause a havoc here on earth, because then we'll be rushing after other people's partners, because really we do not know who's our partner. I think once you fall in love and you agree that I love this person, surely the gods join in and say, yes, here you go, that is your partner.